Previously, I mentioned that REST is more of a set of guidelines than a protocol itself. This is because it takes the HTTP protocol and applies a few constraints to clarify communication and resource management. In this video, I will go more in depth as to what these constraints mean for us as API developers. The first constraint of a RESTful implementation is the separation of clients and servers. A client is defined as a machine requesting a resource, where the server is the machine that responds with the requested resource. A machine can function as a client and as a server, but for the duration of an HTTP request and response cycle, it must assume the role as either the requester of the information or the holder of that information. A stateful architecture remembers a client's activity between requests. If you've ever used a website where you have a shopping cart or login session, it appears as though the server is remembering your activity throughout the duration of your time on the website. A truly RESTful architecture, however, is not allowed to retain information about the state of another machine during the communication process. Each request from a client to a server must be treated as though it was the first request the server has ever seen from that client. A server should not remember its clients and readjust its state accordingly. The server may only give back the most up-to-date information about its state to the client and allow for modifications if the client is authorized to do so. In Lesson 4, you will see how using tokens is a good way to have a stateless design that can create an experience that seems state-remembering to the user. Response messages from the server to the client are explicitly labeled as cacheable or non-cacheable. This way, responses can be cached by the client if the information on the server hasn't changed since the last request. RESTful architectures must have a uniform interface between all clients and servers. For example, a server must not require a different way of accessing data if a client is a Windows laptop versus an iPhone or a Unix server. Gaining access to these endpoints is the same for any machine trying to access this information. A layered system means that a client can have access to an endpoint that relies on other endpoints without having to know and understand all of the underlying implementations. If client A wants to communicate with server B, and that server goes out to Google or some other database in order to generate a response, client A should not have to accommodate for any other technologies besides accessing server B's endpoint. Layering allows very complicated tasks to be completed without having to understand all of the underlying complexities that were required to generate the response. Code on demand is an optional constraint for RESTful applications, but it opens the possibility for code, like JavaScript for example, from the server to be sent off to the client for execution. For more about the RESTful constraints, feel free to check out some of the links I provided in the instructor notes.